Sangeeta Gupta, your Reiki Grandmaster for more than 25 years. And today I'm going to talk about confusions, myths regarding Reiki, and where should you should learn Reiki 1, where should you should learn Reiki 2, and what is the difference between Reiki 1, Reiki 2, and Reiki 3A level. And there's so many Reikis happening all around the world. So people are getting very confused. Some people are mentioning Kundalini Reiki, Sanjeevani Reiki, this Reiki, that Reiki, Reiki is emerging as 100 types of Reiki. They're flourishing in the market. Like, you know, you have new pizza toppings. Every person is trying to sell a new pizza, which has more cheese, which has this, which has that. So there is a lot of confusion. There's a lot of difference between pizza and Reiki. And sadly, people have made it very commercial. So it's like, you know, people are trying to get more and more clients, enticing them by adding new fancy names of various Reikis. But Reiki is Reiki. Reiki is universal life force energy that exists everywhere. And whatever names you might call it, it is just one simple universal life force energy which each and every one has a right to create in his or her life. So friends, do not get confused about various names of Reiki, because Reiki is just universal life force energy that was discovered by Dr. Usui. But before he discovered it, was always there. The only thing is that he, in a very structured form, taught to his students from Guru Shishya Parampara, from Guru to his student. It spread worldwide. So please do not be confused about this Reiki, that Reiki. That Reiki is more powerful. That falan Reiki is more powerful. So do not get confused about it. Let me tell you what happens in Reiki. So Reiki is very simple form of energy we are receiving from the universe through our chakras. That's a very common thing that happens to us. So what a Reiki master does is cleanses all your chakras, works on your Kundalini energy. Kundalini energy is nothing but, you know, energy which is stored in your chakras, and especially your root chakra. And a Reiki master will cleanse your chakras and attune you to the energies of Reiki. So it is very important to get tuned into Reiki energies by getting cleansed by a Reiki master preferably. So in Reiki 1, the energies are little gross in a person, because the person has lot of negative conditionings, lot of negative thoughts, lot of negative emotions. So in Reiki 1, the process of cleansing takes place very slowly, and a person gets clearer and clearer as the day passes by. So one day is required for you to get an understanding of Reiki healing, to understand what Reiki is, the history of Reiki, and that's what we do in Reiki 1. And after attunement, you can do touch healing on yourself. The basic thing that is covered in Reiki 1 is cleansing of the chakras and having the energy start to flow in the funnel of energy which is there in the spinal cord. So the spinal cord gets cleaned up and the energy starts flowing. So please do not get confused about that. I have been observing these leaders who have come out with beautiful fancy names, and you can create your own names. You know, after you learn Reiki 1, 2, 3 and Mastership, you can create your own Reiki. I can create Sangeeta Reiki, I can create Govardhan Reiki, I can create Krishna Reiki, I can create Saraswati Reiki. But that's a very commercial point of creating Reiki. So I would really request people not to get confused by names. These are names, but energy remains the same. Whatever a person does is the same thing. Energy is universally the same. So one has to understand the basic structure of Reiki. Reiki works on cleansing of the chakras in person's body. So, and then the attuning is done. In the second degree Reiki, which you can do immediately the second day of Reiki 1. After doing Reiki 1, immediately you can go for Reiki 2. And in Reiki 2, you learn the old traditional Dr. Usui symbols of Reiki, which are 3 in number. There are only 3 symbols in Reiki 2. A lot of people I find these days, they give those symbols in Reiki 1, which is not required, which should not be given because we are doing traditional Reiki. So in traditional Reiki, Reiki 1 is without symbols. Reiki 2 has 3 symbols: power symbol, mental and emotional symbol, and distant healing symbol. So these 3 symbols suffice, and you start practicing it for 21 days. When you practice for 21 days, you are cleansing your whole body and your body gets charged up, and you release the toxins. And after doing your own healing, you can do healing for others as well within this period of 21 days. It is not advisable to do healing of others very frequently in these 21 days, but you can do half an hour of healing for your family, for your close friends in these 21 days after doing your own healing work. That way you will not catch any negativity or any bad energy from anybody else. And then after doing 21 days, you can go in for Reiki advanced healing technique. In this, you get master symbol, which was given by Dr. Usui, and there is an attunement in this one as well. And then the energy flow that happens is just awesome after doing the third degree. So I really recommend people to at least who are healers to go till third degree Reiki. So in doing third degree Reiki, you will have Master Usui symbol, and the energy flow is awesome after doing the advanced Reiki training. In the advanced Reiki training, there are certain techniques that are also given, but they're not part of Reiki. Like, you know, there's a crystal grid, there's a Reiki meditation, there's psychic surgery. These 3 things have been added on, and they enhance your powers of energy. So you can do that. Crystal healing, then psychic surgery, all these will enhance your powers as a healer. And then you can become a Reiki Grandmaster. You needn't wait for very long to undergo these trainings. So it is like, this course can be completed in 1 month's time, and you can become a very powerful Reiki Grandmaster and a Reiki healer. So friends, my request to you is, don't get confused by fancy names. Reiki or healing modalities work through your intentions, your intention to heal, your love and compassion for the person you want to heal. And it is the same energy. So whatever fancy names you want to give, you can give. You can also create your own fancy names for commercial use to incite the customers. But don't do that. The commercial way is very disrespectful to Reiki. So don't come up with fancy names of Reiki. Reiki is just Reiki. Please do not be confused with fancy names that are added to Reiki. So that's what I wanted to share with you authentically. I hope your doubts about various kind of Reikis has been solved, because there's only one Reiki, and the fancy names are just a commercial way to tell people I'm doing better than the than other people in this world. And people give fancy, I'm doing this extra, I'm doing that extra, I'm teaching this, I'm teaching that. But I understand that the traditional way is the best way, and it is a very complete way of learning Reiki. So do not get duped. Do not get duped in this world of Reiki, which is very pure and simple. So thank you, friends. If you really want to learn authentic Reiki, if you want to learn exact Reiki, how it works, you can come in for Reiki sessions, Reiki healing courses, all the levels. Thank you. My numbers are given. Do contact me and do write in the comment box, how did you like this session? Thank you. Bye-bye.